you seriously bring a whole ass iPad to a speed dating event?
Yeah, Ravens are playing. I wasn't gonna miss it.
You like the Ravens? That checks out. You also look like you once had a good run, but are far past your prime at this point. Did you just nag me? But I'll forgive you, because the Ravens are one of the only teams that have a marching band, and they get their name from Edgar Allan Poe, and I'm an Edgar Allan Ho. All I understood about what you just said was the word ho, but that's enough to keep me intrigued. I'm not looking for anything serious, by the way. Oh, me neither, sweetie. Great! Do you have a secretly delicate ego that you're overcompensating with raw sexual machismo to protect you from any real intimacy too? Oh no, honey. I'm just fun. Cool. These speed dating events really drain me. What do you say we get out of here, pick up some food, and go watch a movie at my place? I mean, I have been here for a while and basically talked to everyone already, and I'm dying to try this new Tex-Mex place down the block and watch that new documentary on essential oils, so I'm game. All right, well, I don't know if I'll like this new Tex-Mex place. I've never tried it before, and if I'm being honest with myself, I'd rather watch a nature slideshow screensaver on my Apple TV than watch a documentary on anything, but I already committed to asking you out, so what are you doing? Hey, girly. Yeah, so I met someone at this speed dating event, and they have an Apple TV, so we can watch the Essential Oils documentary. I know. Same. I low-key kind of want to join an MLM just because it would be a fascinating social experiment. You're inviting your friend? Yeah, I mean, TBH isn't really my type long term, but you're hot, so I figured we could have a threesome instead.
Why do I even bother dating?
Girl, you're so fun. Girl, you're so fun.
Girl, stop.
No, girl, really. Okay, girl, like, I know.
No, girl, but seriously?
Yeah, girl?
I don't usually ask this of people that I just met, but I think you would be a really great fit for my direct sales team.
Stop.
No, girl, seriously. Have you ever thought of selling essential oils?
Yeah, so my parents got divorced when I was really young, so it's been pretty tough to open up and trust people in my adult life. It's like I've got this big shell around me, but inside is just this delicate inner child that just wants to be loved. And even though my parents got divorced, my grandparents had always had this very sweet, loving relationship I really looked up to. My greatest dream was just always to have a relationship like theirs.
Aww.
Then, just recently actually, my grandfather was killed by their pool boy who'd been having an affair with my grandmother for years behind his back. He strangled him with a hose in a fit of rage and jealousy. That's really insensitive of you. That wasn't supposed to be funny. I dedicated my whole life to becoming a teacher because I admired my grandmother so much. Now, I don't know why you're acting surprised. One of the first things I told you is that I'm a teacher. Excuse me, are you even listening to me?
I'm sorry, what? I wasn't very interested in what you were saying, so I just put on a podcast.
I'm so sorry about the food at this place. If I would ever take you out myself, I wouldn't dream of taking you to a place that didn't even have fabric tablecloths.
I know, if you're gonna top the tables with paper, you at least gotta give us crayons.
I like you, you're funny.
Oh, I try. So what do you do for work?
Oh, I'm a trust fund baby with a podcast.
Get out of town. I always wanted to be a freeloader. Where does your money come from? Oh, and what's your podcast about?
I love how many questions you're asking me. My dad's family owns a chain of luxury gas stations. My mother is a real housewife, and my podcast is about me.
Wow, I love it. Celebrity gossip, right from the source.
You're the first person to finally rightfully call me a celebrity. What do you say we go to a restaurant with a real tablecloth and I buy you your favorite look from one of the past 10 Met Gala red carpets?
I mean, did you hear me when I said that I always wanted to be a freeloader or what? Tell me more about luxury gas stations.
So it's like, think of an airport lounge, right? But one that you would stay in like Dubai. Like not one of those shitty Delta ones, you know? So like picture that, right? But like a gas station. And someone else even pumped your gas for you.
You know, one of my biggest pet peeves is someone who talks with their mouth full.
Really? That's interesting. I always thought that, like, the heart of the meal was always the conversation that you had.
So, what do you like?
I don't know. What do you like?
Gosh, I don't know. I like so much.
Oh my gosh, no way. Me too.
No way, really? Like what?
I don't know. Just, like, name anything.
Okay, what do you think about Star Wars?
Oh my god, I love Star Wars. Baby Yoda is so cute.
Oh my god, totally. But isn't Baby Yoda technically from The Mandalorian?
Oh my god, yeah, you're totally right. You're so smart, oh my gosh.
I love that you think that about me. Do you watch The Bachelor?
I am so sad that Zach and Tayshia broke up.
Me too! And talk about Katie Thurston's 12 Days of Messy. I mean, can you believe it?
So messy, it almost makes me sick. But I also like, kinda love it.
Yes, talk about bringing you over to the dark side. Are you gonna watch Colton's new Netflix show?
Colton Underwood is a despicable, manipulative abuser and he should be canceled. Sign my petition to have Netflix take down his show.
Restraining order aside, I even think it's pretty disturbing that it's using his sexuality in this way to try and reverse his public image and propel his career to stay relevant.
You're so right. He's a really bad person.
So what gives? You gonna watch it?
I mean, how could I not?
I know.
I don't usually care for the speed dating sort of thing, but can't help but think that in a world in which my existence is so futile and impermanent, the one thing that could make life worth living is to know someone so intimately that I could bare my soul to the point of losing all sense of ego that traps me in this paradigm of human suffering.
Cool. Very interesting. Do you like true crime?
Yeah, dude, I fucking love true crime.
To drink milk from a species other than your own is impeding on that animal's freedom, and the propaganda and government subsidization of animal products is contributing to the obesity epidemic in this country, if it is not already one of the main factors.
If we do not continue to subsidize animal agriculture, then you are destroying the livelihoods of poor people with family-owned farms. Don't you care about small family-owned businesses?
It is immoral to forcibly impregnate a cow and take away its calf for slaughter.
So you're saying that children should no longer be able to drink breast milk from their mothers?
That's not what I'm saying at all!
So you wouldn't take the COVID vaccine because it impedes with the freedom of Americans?
How does this conversation equate at all to vaccines?
I'm just saying, judging by your logic,
that is a much more nuanced conversation.
I think I love you.
Would you like to go on another date sometime?
Okay, so what you're gonna do when you get home is you're gonna open an account with Fidelity Investments.
Okay, great.
And from there, you're gonna create your Roth IRA account.
This is really useful, thank you so much.
You can set up a monthly recurring payment from your checking account to your Roth IRA account. Given your age, I would suggest about $220 a month.
$220.
Once you can access that money in your retirement, the great thing is that none of it is taxable, so you're golden.
Amazing. But here's the thing that people forget to tell you sometimes. You don't just wanna deposit the money into your Roth IRA. Once you do that, you're also gonna wanna invest it.
Okay.
Yeah. I really appreciate you listening to my 3-minute spiel on the heinous acts of Colton Underwood. It really means a lot. I don't think I've ever felt this understood in my life, and I'd really like to see you again.
Really?
Yes, really. Why?
I don't know, just something about your attitude. I thought you hated me.
I don't hate you.
actually really, really like you.
I'm so relieved. You don't hate me.
Yeah, so I feel really vulnerable here, but would you like to get a coffee sometime? Wow, I've never extended myself to such a level of commitment before.
Yeah, sure. I might flake out a couple of minutes before we're supposed to meet up, but it's not about you, don't take it personally.
Honestly, nothing would make me more relieved. I can't express to you how much these past 3 minutes of speed dating with you have meant to me, but I'd like to try. Here's a series of haikus I wrote about our time together. Those eyes of yours brown. With you I feel lost, yet found. Your mind so complex. I don't understand. And yet, I do feel so deep. You could be the one. Our time may be short, but it is all I need to know I'm yours.
Oh my god. Oh man, you have no idea how much I have to thank you for. I haven't been able to sleep in days. I was so overstimulated. I felt like I was on speed. No pun intended. But you amazing creature, you did it. Oh man, thank you so much. I'll catch you on the flip.
They said they'd catch me on the flip.